Caleb. So tell us about what's being done in terms of the London Compact on our side and the resilience plan. I don't know what is being done right now and how do you see this going?
Thank you, Your Excellency. Good morning to all. It's a great pleasure to be at EIB-EDAMA. Also, it's an important occasion that we share the stage with EIB, which is one of the critical financing agencies with a great and strategic partner for Jordan, like the European Union. For the government, truly resilience is very much at the heart of our development agenda. I would even argue that resilience is very much part of the Jordanian genetic code. I think everyone realizes that the region we live in and the geopolitical location of Jordan has forced us over the many decades to build resilience into everything we do. And over the many decades, I would say, and the years, what keeps Jordan resilient is very much a combination of the leadership we have, the citizens we have in Jordan, commitment to keeping Jordan a safe and stable oasis, and I think also a commitment to a continued path, even with setbacks back and forth, to comprehensive homegrown reforms on all tracks. We are currently, as a country, as a nation, on our 10-year roadmap under the Jordan 2025. And if people recall, when we launched the Jordan 2025 with a very bottom-up approach, there were twin critical goals in it. Sustaining the resilience while increasing prosperity of the nation. It's very much inherent because we live in a neighborhood, whether we like it or not. Disruptions and exogenous shocks are going to keep spinning over into our homeland. And at the same time, we have to do our homework as a government in partnership with the private sector and civil society to increase prosperity and develop the reforms. And as part of that, the government translates this 10-year roadmap through a tool called the Executive Development Program. This is the 3-year rolling plan where we build all the priorities of reform, projects, initiatives, that we have to do every 3 years with all the indicators, key performance indicators and requirements, and we track them and we keep moving this based on the government priorities and the government program that gets submitted obviously to Parliament and receives a vote of confidence with every new government. These executive development programs are very much the tool right now that we are integrating into the sustainable development goals of 2030. And at the same time, that framework that we use as a government in moving forward is built also on a governorate or what we call regional development plans that are built bottom up on 3 principles or 3 pillars. We scan every region in Jordan. We look at its competitive advantage or advantages. We look at its development assessment, call it a SWOT analysis or whatever. And based on that, we define what are the needed government interventions, what is the investment map for this region based on what its characteristics or comparative advantages, and what is the role also, and here of course the role of the private sector, and finally, what is the role of the civil society through cooperatives, NGOs, women and youth organizations, to create entrepreneurship, micro, small projects, or self-employment productive initiatives. I think there is slowly a change in the way government does things, a clear realization that government can't do everything. And you need a deeper and better partnership with the private sector, and you need to engage a new mindset of shifting also part of the development burden and interventions on civil society and the different organizations with that. You want me to stop with that? Continue, or we need to manage my
time. We can come back.